Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. In this video, I will show you how to apply one of the most popular API design patterns to your entities. We will create Fluent entities. They make your code extremely easy to read, but implementing Fluent entities with JPA and Hibernate is not as easy as you might expect. But before we begin, if this is your first time here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Fluent interfaces are a popular API design pattern in the Java world. The goal of the pattern is to create APIs that are very easy to read and that define something similar to a domain-specific language. To achieve that, the API heavily relies on method chaining so that the code that uses the API flows and almost reads like prose. A basic example of a Fluent API might look like this. As you can see, the code looks more like a description of a book object and not like a technical piece of code that calls multiple setter methods. APIs like these are often used for value classes and configuration data. So it's no surprise that a lot of teams would like to use them for entities. Unfortunately, that's not as easy as you might expect. The JPA specification requires your entities to follow the Java Beans introspector convention. It says, in this case, for every persistence property, property of type T of the entity, there is a getter method, getProperty, and setter method, setProperty. For Boolean properties, isProperty may be used as an alternative name for the getter method. For single-valued persistence properties, these method signatures are tGetProperty and voidSetProperty. So if you want to create JPA-compliant entities, you need to implement public getter and setter methods for all entity attributes. If you also wish to provide a Fluent interface API, you can only add these methods so that both APIs coexist on the same class. Hibernate is not as strict as the JPA specification, but it still recommends to follow the Java Beans convention. It says, although Hibernate does not require it, it is recommended to follow the Java Bean conventions and define getters and setters for entity persistent attributes. The interesting part in this quote is, Hibernate does not require it. So if you decide to ignore the JPA specification and potential portability issues, Hibernate allows you to implement a clean, Fluent interface API for your entities. The decision is up to you. Do you need to support multiple JPA implementations? Then you should provide JPA-compliant getter and setter methods. Otherwise, you can design a cleaner API. In the following sections, I will show you a JPA-compliant and a Hibernate-compliant way to implement a Fluent interface API. Let's start with the JPA-compliant implementation. If you want to implement your entities in a JPA-compliant way, you will not be able to design a nice and clean Fluent interface API. You can only add the Fluent methods to your entity class and keep the getter and setter methods. When you use the book entity in your business code, you can decide which API you want to use. You can call the getter and setter methods, or you can use the methods of the Fluent interface API. As described earlier, Hibernate recommends providing getter and setter methods that follow the Java Beans convention. But it doesn't require these methods. That gives you higher flexibility when designing the API of your entities. You can decide if you provide a Fluent API by changing the setter methods so that they return the entity object, or if you provide different methods instead. Let's take a look at both options in the IDE. Changing the return type of your setter methods is a simple and very flexible approach. The API of your entity looks almost identical to a JPA-compliant entity, and you can still call all setter methods as you would usually do. That enables you to add the Fluent API without changing any existing business code. And you can also change the calls of your setter methods to use them fluently. But this code snippet also shows the downside of this approach. Even though you change the method calls, the code still reads like you're calling multiple setter methods. It doesn't flow. If you want to take it one step further, you need to annotate your primary key attribute with @ID. That tells Hibernate to use the field-based access strategy. You then don't need to provide any setter or getter methods for your entity attributes. That enables you to rename these setter methods to create a real Fluent interface. In this example, I removed the word set from the setTitle method, changed the name of the setPublishingDate method to publishedOn, and renamed the setAuthors method to writtenBy. As you can see in the following code snippet, the new method names drastically improve the readability of the business code. It now almost reads like you're describing the book, and it's no longer a list of technical calls of setter methods. One thing you need to be aware of when you implement your API like this is that the Fluent Interface API doesn't affect your JPQA queries. You still use the attribute names in your query. That might get a little bit confusing because they no longer match the method names that you use in your business code. The Fluent Interface pattern makes APIs much easier to read. Unfortunately, the JPA specification requires you to provide setter and getter methods for all entity attributes. That prevents you from implementing a clean, Fluent API. You can only add the Fluent methods in addition to the technical getter and setter methods. Hibernate doesn't define the method signature of your setter methods as strictly as JPA does. So you can change the return type of your setter methods to the entity class. That enables you to chain the calls of your setter methods, but the business code still looks very technical and doesn't flow. If you tell Hibernate to use field-based access, you can rename your setter methods and design a real Fluent API. But please keep in mind that you still need to reference the attribute names in your JPQA query. Some developers find this confusing because the attribute and method names no longer match. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!